Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In this series, we are looking into the concept of stateflow and how it works in MATLAB. In this video, we will be looking into how we can set debugging points in the states of a stateflow chart. So let's get started. As you can see over here, we are now inside the stateflow chart. So let's drag some points. Let's create a state, which is the on state by default. So this is the on state, and here, or we will be making this as off state, and we will keep one more state, which will be the on state. We will be transiting from off to on when SW equal to 1, and we will be transiting from on to off when SW equal to 0. So suppose I want some conditions, like we have seen already, we have an entry condition and we have a during condition and we have a exit condition. So we define all. Now entry en colon x equal to 1, du colon y equal to y plus 1, ex colon z equal to z plus 1. So for the on state also, en colon a equal to 1, du colon b equal to b plus 1, and ex colon c equal to c plus 1. And we will need to initialize all this same in the default transition. So we will be doing that. We will be setting x equal to 0, comma y equal to 0, comma z equal to 0, comma a equal to 0, and b equal to 0, then c equal to 0. So everything we have initialized to 0. And now when I try to simulate this particular model, then it will throw me some error because I have defined some extra symbols. So let's go to the symbol wizard and define all these things as the local, because local will not have impact on outside of the state chart. So press on OK. And now we have a switch called SW. So let's use this and add a constant. So let's connect this constant. Done. So we already have a input, so how we can delete that? We will go over the model explorer on top, and then inside this we have the chart, and inside the chart we don't need this one. We will right click on this and we will press on the delete. Okay, we have a delete button over on top, so we'll click on that. So that got deleted. Now we will not have the port. Now we have now the single port. So by clicking on this, you will be able to browse your different components of the state flow chart. This is called the model explorer. So now pressing on the spacebar, the model is organized. Now let's start adding debugging point inside the states. So in here, if I right click on any of the state, set breakpoint, there are three options that I am getting. One is on state entry, one is on state during, and one is on the exit. So let's use the state on entry. So whenever this is being entered, the simulation will be paused and we will be able to see the variables. So if I simulate it, okay, now it got paused over here. So simulation is paused just before entering off state. It is written on the downside, as you can see. So now suppose something we want to see. So before entering, everything is 0. So it is showing x equal to 0, y equal to 0, everything 0. Here also a, b, c all are 0. So this is how you will be debugging at the entry state. Now I will stop the simulation again and right click, set debugging point to the during. Now if I play this, then it is written just before entering the off state. Let's see what is actually happening. Okay, I'll stop the simulation, remove the debugging point. Okay, it has checked both. So that's why we are at the entry state debugging. Now we will be doing only during state debugging. So let's play it. Yeah, now the model is running. As we are not able to enter inside the during state because the condition over here got satisfied, so that's why no during state is there. So this is how you will be able to see like whether any during state is happening or not. Okay, let's stop the simulation and change the condition to false by setting it to 0. Now let's play this simulation. Now you are at the during state for the pop state. So on the bottom you can see we are at the during state, and if you see the values, then only the value of x is changed and the remaining values are 0. So now if I stop the simulation and again right click on the set debugging point for exit. So before this I need to remove the during one and I need to set the debugging point for the exit. So when it is exiting, then only it will set the debugging point. So now if I simulate this model, it will be in this state at the op state. And now if I change the condition over here to 1, then the debugger will be activated, because now here we are going to exit the state because this particular condition is now satisfied. Because of that, we are at the debugging point. So this is how you will be doing the debugging at different conditions of the state, like the entry state, exit state, and the during state. All these states you can use your debugger to set, and you can analyze your model using these debuggers. So this is how you will be debugging the whole state. So you can put a debugger at individual states, and as we have already seen, we can keep debuggers on the transition as well in the previous tutorial. In case you are liking our channel, please consider subscribing and press on the bell icon for the latest updated notifications. In case you have any comment or suggestions, please share it in the comment box so that we can improve your experience of learning MATLAB in this channel. Happy learning MATLAB and stay connected. Thank you.